Welcome back, Dark Souls. Today we're going to be checking out the spell Profound Steel, which I have named my mage killer build because point blank it kills mages. Profound Steel requires you to have 42 faith and 20 intelligence. Also, you need 2 attunement slots just to equip the spell, but it is totally worth it. The spell works on all types of casters: pyromancy, faith, lightning, magic, dark magic, all that stuff. Especially pure mages will be very vulnerable, forcing them to fight you in a more, man-to-man kind of battle. But if you're like me, 42 faith and 20 intelligence is a lot to sacrifice and pretty heavy investment. But the great news is that you can actually lower the minimum requirements needed to use this spell by spicing it down. This guy is the guy you need to know in order to do that. Now you go to the spell, you use incense, and for the faith part, you're gonna use the skeptic spice. For the intelligence part, to lower that, you're gonna use the simpleton spice. And as you can see, it's going down one by one, from 16 to 15 to 14, and you can see it's gonna go all the way down to 10. Now what you're gonna do is just switch over, go to the skeptic spice, and lower down the faith requirement. And from this point, all you need is 10 intelligence and 10 faith in order to use this spell to stop mages dead in their tracks. I use it all the time. It's hilarious to watch them just squirm. Now, with that being said, you know, this spell also gives, a mage who knows how to use it a pretty clear advantage. If you can stop the other caster from casting, they can't, attack, and you're the only one casting on the field, so you pretty much have a good advantage if, mages want to use it. You need a sacred chime to cast this. So let's see it in action. Let's go kill some mages. First up, flip raptor. Let's whoop on him a bit. First, I cast it. He's disabled. At this point, you can see he wants to run back. He wants to cast. Look at him. He wants to do it. He can't do it. This guy. He hits me with the first one, not the second. Another reason that I cast Great Magic Barrier. Sometimes you get hit with the first one if they onto your game, knowing that you're gonna block their magic. The mages normally do one or two things. Either they keep trying to cast, pretty much like an idiot, or they try to fight you head up, man to man, or they just run around for the entire bit. But how long can they really run? Not long at all. Stops them. I mean, what are you gonna do without your magic? What are you gonna do? Nothing. Oh yeah, this guy, I don't support AFKers. They deserve to be punished severely. And this guy was just lucky I was feeling good that day. I thought he was actually trying to psych me out by just standing there like a statue. So I slapped him around a little bit. Knock him back to his senses. And I just pretty much assume everybody is a caster, so I just hit him with it. Pretty much everybody's packing around some kind of magic. Zeke, there you go. Look, there you go. They can't beat you with a sword. They normally switch up and start casting, as a backup. See, he didn't even have much health. He's what you call a glass cannon. Pull all his points into magic, hoping to one-shot you. But not today. That's right, run. He's running. He's just running. He doesn't know what to do. So I just help him die. Alright, what are we going to do here? Another victim of profound steel. He can't cast, so what else is there left? Suicide. Not on my watch. Not on my watch. You're gonna leave this world. You're gonna leave by my hand. You're gonna die. Well, there you have it. That's Profound Steel, the Mage Killer build. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe. Until next time.